is nothing cozier than wearing a really yummy, smushy flannel shirt this time of year. And Orly is here with an easy, no-sew way to dress up this classic shirt that all of us love.
Yeah.
But, you know, unfortunately, they kind of come and go out of style unless you have Orly Shani in your life.
Yeah, well, you know what? You're so right. Sometimes they're either really, really on trend and flannels are everywhere, but no matter what, I feel like they always mean something to us. Like, we never get rid of them.
It's so true.
We hold them forever. And you have a perfect example of this.
Perfect example. Okay, let me show you these two shirts. Now, about four seasons ago, I brought these in. This isn't even a joke. These are John's old flannels. And we were cleaning out the closet. He didn't want them anymore. And I said, no, but I love them and I want to wear them. And I said, I'm going to bring them to work because I know Orly will do something with them. And here we are. I knew the day would come, Orly.
Well, the thing that I love so much about this is it's a perfect example of a way that you could take something that it means a lot to you.
Yeah.
These are your husband's flannels, but you can add a little bit of your style, a little bit of trends that matter to you, colors, vibes that are you, and it's a perfect mix of those things.
So, and make them a little more feminine.
Exactly. Yeah, a lot of feminine touches here, which is really fun. So that's what we're going to do. You can see the one that I'm wearing, I added like crystals all over it, and I did this really pretty like amber color. And so I did sort of a saturation on the pocket, and then throughout, you can see they're just sort of sprinkled throughout, so it just picks up the light and adds a little bit of glitz to it.
Yeah, it's really
You can
pretty.
Also do beautiful floral patches. There's really high-end brands that do this that are very, very expensive. Or even adding, like this one over here, the green one, a ruffle trim that just emphasizes the pattern that already exists on the shirt with a little bit of texture and femininity.
And it's probably a little easier, so that is what I'm going to stick to while you show everyone else how to do the more detailed ones. So first we have to start by figuring out where we want to place our bedazzles.
Exactly. And there's no right way, but Debbie, what I would say is just look at it. What's easy is that there's already perfect, like a roadmap for you because there's already checkers and lines and stripes.
Right.
So decide which ones you want to highlight, and that's where you're going to attach your ruffle trim to the stripes that already exist on your shirt.
Okay.
It's like a roadmap, so it's super easy, and you just pick which road you want to take.
Okay. Now, and I imagine if I'm using one with stretch, I shouldn't stretch it.
Exactly, and that's actually a really important point. A lot of these ruffle trims that you're going to find are elastic ruffle trims, so you want to make sure that you're not stretching them when you're gluing them, or when they dry, it's going to elastic your shirt up.
Okay.
So just keep that in mind. Now, one of the ones I want to do here is this floral one. So there are patches like this. These are actually readily available online. This is a cherry blossom patch, and it is an iron-on patch, which means the backside already has like an adhesive of some sort. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go down here on the bottom. It looks really cool. I always think to have it look like it's growing out from the bottom of the hem.
I love that.
So what you want to do is if it's something like this, make sure that you're not seeing the shiny side up because that's the glue. So make sure that you turn everything facing down that you can have, and now we're simply going to iron it. Now, what I like to do when I'm doing iron-on patches is we gotta turn that steam off one second.
And I love that iron-on patch, by the way. You made Alexandra some pants with that same patch.
Yes.
Last season.
And I saved them because I ended up with more than I needed and I knew they would come in handy. So these are great. You can buy a lot of these. Now, what I like to do is I like to iron it face up so I can ensure that I'm keeping it in the right spot. Once it's done, then I will flip this inside out and iron it from the back underneath side with a lot more heat and a lot more like a length of time.
To make
that's
sure it
really,
stays.
Yeah, that's really gonna make sure it stays. So basically you would line this up, do the whole thing. For time's sake, I wanna move on to two more styles.
Okay, can I ask you, how would Please. We take care of these?
So depending on what you used, you can machine wash or you can dry clean, hand wash always. If you're using fabric glue, it is machine washable, but I would say you normally get like 3 or 4 washes before it starts to come apart and you'll have to apply more glue.
Okay.
Now for patches like this that don't have an adhesive, what you're gonna wanna do is either hand sew them or fabric glue them. So here, I'm just gonna sort of decide on where I would want these. You can lay them out and come up with your design. This would be really pretty, kind of cascading down the shoulder.
Yeah.
And then again, I would use a little bit of fabric glue. You can just outline it, it doesn't need a lot. You would just put a little bit of glue all on the outside and then sort of dab it down. Once this side is down, now you can kind of fold this side back, add your glue, and fold it back down.
So cute.
And the last one I wanna talk about is if you're gonna add embellishments, like actual individual crystals or
like
pearls.
Like what you have on your shirt.
Exactly. And a fun thing to do, and I'm gonna do that right over here, is plot your points with your glue. So I'm gonna do these tiny little just like this. This is basically allowing me to see where I'm gonna put them and save a ton of time.
And so I know you always say choose ahead of time and then glue, but with something like this, do you kind of just have to freehand or
what?
Well,
yeah, you kind of can, especially because if you do something like I did, again, like I said, the roadmap from our flannel exists. So on my shirt, and actually I'm gonna step back so you can see it, what I did is I decided where I wanted my larger crystals. So you can see I've got like larger crystals here, right? Every other. Mm-hmm. Then in between those, I put my small ones. So it's literally like you're playing checkers with your shirt and your crystals. You decide where the first ones are going to go and you fill in the gaps. And that's the thing that's so easy is it's literally, there's all these lines and all you have to do is follow the lines.
Follow
you don't have to measure. Just follow the lines.
This is so fun.
I know. It really is a great way to add a little bit of femininity and style to something that's kind of traditionally masculine.
Now, is there a specific glue that you like, it would Fabri-Tac or E6000, either one?
That's a great question. No, if you're using a gem, hardware, pearls, crystals, you want a gem glue. So that would be a Gemtac, E6000, something like that. If you're doing fabric to fabric bonding, which is what you're doing, a fabric trim to a fabric t-shirt, you want a fabric glue, and that's like Fabri-Tac. So a gem glue would not work for that, and a fabric glue would not work for this.
I mean, I know I haven't gotten very far, but I have to be honest with you. This is so cute. So I'm going to do this beautiful trim around here. I'm going to put it around the collar, and then I might even zhuzh it up some more. And I might even do a little extra bedazzle of, so I'm going to need your E6000.
I love that. I'll chuck it over to you.
You chuck it over to me right
now.
Great. Look at how cute that is.
And you don't have to do a lot. That's the one thing I'd say. Like, even just the cuff is a cool detail. You could be done.
Just the cuff.
Yeah. Exactly.
That is super cute, Orly. I love this project.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for sharing this. For full instructions, you all can head on over to HallmarkChannel.com.